Alright guys, so I look crazy, I know, I'm sorry if I scared anybody, but I'm going to be filming my everyday foundation routine recently, and that is involving skincare, concealer, foundation, contour, and blush, and highlight as well. All those things will be combined. I'm basically going to be filming my foundation routine today, my eyebrow routine today, and my favorite eye look. I think in my foundation routine I'm going to include a lip. So let's go ahead and get started. I can't really see anything, so I'm going to be using a mirror. If you are going to wonder why I'm looking over here, my mirror is right here. So first I'm going to start off by moisturizing my skin with the Aveeno Positively Radiant Daily Moisturizer. Let me tell you, I've only been using this for, well, I've used this before in the past. Oh, by the way, my nails are crazy. But anyway, I've used this before in the past, really enjoyed it. It was like my go-to moisturizer. I used it for everything. I have to take this ring off because it's scratching my face. But I use this all the time. Then I decided, I don't know if I like it anymore, so I decided to try something new. Never will I ever try anything new because, let me tell you, this is the best thing I've ever used. It's like great. I can't even explain to you how great it is already, and I think I bought this, I think I've had it for like 5 days again now, and my skin is noticeably softer. This is supposed to help, what's it supposed to help do? Let me think. Even your tone, texture, all that fun stuff, and it also has sunscreen. So it's a really great moisturizer, and it's already evened out the texture of my skin, which I'm just like, yes. Okay, moving on to lips, just to moisturize my lips. I'm gonna put on some Jack Black Lip Therapy Balm. These are all my favorite products, by the way. So if you wanna see everything and mini reviews, I'll have my March favorites linked down below, which I know is kinda late because it'll probably be up in like a week or so. So anyway, now I'm going to move on to I don't know what I'm moving on to because I just like lost my brain. Okay, I'm moving on to foundation. This is the NYC it's kind of rainy today. This is the NYC Smooth Skin Liquid Makeup. I'm in the shade Ivory. But anyway, there's no pump. It's a struggle, but I really enjoy this foundation a lot, so you know, while we're waiting for our freaking moisturizer to soak in a little bit, this takes like no time to like soak into your skin. Check. Okay, I think I got some. I hope. Maybe it'll come out easy, I don't know. But you don't need very much of this, which is great, and it's like pretty much medium to full coverage, and it's only like $4, and it hasn't like broken me out. This is just from probably stress. And this is from stress. So, I'll probably need more than this. Oh, I forgot to do my favorite part. I'll do it after. Who? So, I don't use very much foundation because of my concealer. Like, I don't really need that much because of what I do with my concealer stuff. You'll see momentarily what I do. But yeah. You think I'm all about to grab a Sigma brush? No, girls. I'm going to grab my Bare Minerals Heavenly Face Brush. Yes, I am. Not spraying it or anything because otherwise this thing will become streaky. And that's not what you want. So anyway, I'm just going to buff this in and I will be right back. Right back. Okay, guys? Okay, so I'm going to conceal now. Put that on, looking good. I'm gonna go ahead and conceal. I normally conceal before foundation, but I totally got ahead of myself. So anyways, I'm going to use the Anastasia Beverly Hills Eyelights Matte, which needs sharpened, so give me a second. Yeah. Okay, so I take the Anastasia Beverly Hills Eyelights Matte in Camille, and I don't know what I was doing. I was fixing myself. So anyways, this is actually supposed to be for like under the brows, highlighting type of thing. I use it to prime my eyelids and also conceal. You're wondering why I conceal with this product? Because you can totally see it's like pink. It's because I am so fair. Like, I pretty much match this white shirt. No, I'm kidding. But I am so fair that like nothing works. This does. So I wouldn't recommend this if you've got dry under eyes, but I totally recommend this for anybody else because this is like a powder, cream to powder formula, so it's really creamy, but like, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes I conceal my little red spots with this, but not often because it kind of brightens more than, like, it conceals as well, but like, you don't want to like draw attention to the big bump on your face, but this girl does. Alright, so I just blend this with my ring finger. And it just, like, blends in like a dream. And you always want to set this, though. Like, set it, boo. Set it. Even though I did say it was, like, a cream to powder, it's going to settle in your lines if you don't. So just do it. Okay? Alright. Okay. Oh, no, I set my ring finger. I'm going to use whatever finger I want to use. And you don't really need a lot. I just always put on a lot because it's fun to me. But yeah, like I said, just always blend it in. And then sometimes if I'm having some issues, I'll just like come around the edges with my foundation brush. But I don't have any issues today. And then I'm just like brightened and awake and I look alive. Alright, just blend out these edges down here. And I'll be right back. Okay, I'm setting my under eyes now with a fluffy brush. Here it is. And an eyeshadow. Because they don't make powders light enough for me that I like. So I use this guy. And I just really just set right under here. That's all I use it for. And then just whatever's left, I just kind of do one of those. And I'm wearing my boyfriend's shirt today, so that's why I don't look really girly, if we're wondering. Okay, moving on now, and I kind of just set these with whatever's left. Okay, moving on to, let's see, what we call move on to, girls. We're going to move on to, contouring. So, I don't know. I was using the Hoola bronzer. It's like too orange for me. So, I'm moving on to a whole new world. I'm using an eyeshadow. Not this one. This one, here it is. I'm like, where's my eyeshadow? Okay. It's not actually an eyeshadow. It's actually an eyebrow thing. So, I'm just using an eyebrow powder, which you'll see in my eyebrow routine. But you can probably guess who it's by. I'm actually taking the lightest shade and, like, an angled brush, and I'm just, like, squeezing it so I just get the one thing. So I just get the one color because I don't need all three because that would be crazy. Alright, and then I just, like, put it in here. Like a dream. I do like this powder. I do like it for contouring. So I'm thinking about using it for my contouring, like, all the time. And it's, like, my brow color, too, which kind of sucks. So I'm going to have a share. I don't like sharing. Everybody has to have their own thing. I actually used another eyeshadow the other day by NYX. And I don't think it's taupe, but it is, like, a taupey color. Came in some palette, which I'm going to be doing a review on because I don't really like it. It's just that shade, really. Totally just that I saw, like, someone flying outside my window. I didn't see anybody flying. But I thought he did. Alright, I'm going to put some contour up here. Worst part about doing your makeup is, like, your hair just decides to join in. Like, no. Not allowed. This is just where I contour. You don't have to. Okay. Blending this in. Just like a little extra blend to blend. Good to go. My favorite. Bam. My favorite. No, no. My favorite blush. I guess it's just going to come out. Is the Tarte Glisten Cream Blush Cheek Stain thing. Let me just tell you how much I love this. Like, you can't even understand how great it is. So I like to hit myself in the face. You know, to apply this, just hit yourself in the face. Why not? Oh yeah, I tried to prank my, look. Tried to prank my boyfriend yesterday. With my chinchilla. With our chinchilla. And I, like, had put him in a box over here that used to have my nail polishes in. I just haven't, like, thrown it away. I put him in the box. And I put some, I poked holes in it, clearly. And then I, like, put the bags over it, because that's what was on top of it. So I just put the bags back on top. And, like, this box is shut the correct way and everything. And he got out of the box. Because I left the door open to the cage, because I did that one time. So I was like, oh, this will be realistic, because I've done that before. Anyway, I'm going to take a highlighter. This is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Cooling Eye Brightener as a highlight. What? I don't listen to the rules. Okay, anyway. So I, like, literally, this is for April Fool's, by the way, if you're, like, wondering why I was pranking my boyfriend. Anyway. And he got out of the box and was running around our room. And I was, like, my brother came upstairs and was like, why is that open? And I'm like, shh, 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 because Zach, or my boyfriend was right there. And he just looked at me, and we were talking about something, and I'm like, well, are you okay? And so he's like, yeah, and then he went to the bathroom, and then my brother's like, he's running around in your room. I'm like, are we serious right now? Like, we are trying to prank him for April Fool's. I'm like, whatever, just leave him running around. That'll be even better. And then I'm, like, in the closet trying not to laugh, so I'm, like, trying to keep myself occupied. Look how beautiful. And so he comes in, he's like, where's Kowali? And I'm like, what do you mean? And he's like, and as soon as he said that, here comes Kowali hopping into our closet. And I'm like, why can't you pretend you're lost? I knew he was under the bed, because I was like, shut the door. But yeah, that's my little story on my April Fool's prank that, like, my Kowali chinchilla pranked us. Alright, I'm also going to do a lip color, just because my foundation routine is really simple. So I just bought this yesterday, but it's already a favorite, and I didn't get to talk about it in my favorites. So this is the e.l.f. Moisturizing Lipstick in Pink Minx. This is what the packaging looks like, and it's only $3, which is, like, a good deal, like a great deal. And first of all, it wasn't what I thought it was going to be. I thought it was going to be lighter, like in the picture, because I really like those colors, but it's not. It's like this. It's a pretty color. So I'm happy with it regardless. It wasn't what I thought it was going to be, but I love the color. Also, I love the formula. I know, that took, like, forever. Wow. Okay, so I just love this color. It's just, like, so... I always have that, like, nose problem. Anyway, it's just so, like, perfect for spring. It's just, like, this really beautiful pink color that I really am enjoying, and I'm squinting because it's so bright out. It's not even bright outside because it's literally a gloomy day. I don't know what my problem is, but anyways, I'm going to do my eye tutorial next, so you guys will see me in the same lookingness. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. Bye.